Yes. Look, under the status quo right now, it will be so hard for these parents to actually choose to immigrate to another country because how they feel that they have to improve their life to begin with, right? We already told you on how these people choose to immigrate from their original country to American, for example, and so on and so forth, because of how they think that they have no future or improvement for their life if they choose to stay on that country. But beforehand, right, there will be two things in my subtitles. First of all, I would like to talk about the policy making, and second of all, I would like to talk about the likelihood that exists under the status quo. Beforehand, right, first of all, how then, under our side of the house, it will create a better policy making. Look, the moment these immigrants stick together with people who are the same ethnic with them, ladies and gentlemen, who have the same historical background, just to say they will share the same struggles, right, towards the people who are living together with them, towards Mexican, for example, or Chinese who are living in a Chinatown. They're sharing the same historical background, they share the same struggles that they're living in a foreign country, and so on and so forth, right? Look, the moment we are living in ethnic enclave where we are living in the same community, we share the same struggles, it will create a better policy making. Right? Why is that so? First of all, we told you the moment that they are living in one community, the government could hear your demand as a minority better, ladies and gentlemen. You, as an immigrant who are most likely a middle to lower classes, could voice out your demand even better because of how you have the same voices or demand with the people under your community to begin with, right? Like how Mexican people, for example, demand for a better education towards their Mexican children and so on and so forth, right? That's to say the government could provide a better education, for example, or a better infrastructure for those people who are living in the same community as minority to begin with, right? Look, opposition side of the house may told you that the status quo is already progressive and so on and so forth. There's already movement or discrimination law and etc. And your children should not be afraid if these children are going to the public school. But we said no, right? Those movements could not cater the problem that exists under the status quo. Look, discrimination is not only how you get harassed publicly, for example, or even you get harmed by the police in the street and so on and so forth. But look, under the status quo, discrimination comes in a lot of forms. One of them is like how you could get mobbed daily in school continuously, ladies and gentlemen. You could get bullying in the school every day just because you are Chinese, for example, and so on and so forth. There is a lot of bad narrative that these people of majority held upon you as a minority, you as a Chinese, you as a Asian, or even you as a Mexican to begin with, right? This is what we don't want under our set of the house, right? Judges, notice out how the moment government seen us that we are so afraid to mingle with the majority that how we as an immigrant are so afraid to make our children to opt in into public school is that the moment the government will see that there is actually a problem within the status quo to begin with that this government need to fix, right? Like how the reasons why under the status quo all the progressivity that exists under the status quo is not work anymore is because of how the government didn't see the urgency that they need to solve this problem as fast as possible. Look, if we are talking about a children's life, we are also talking about these children's future that they are going to live in this country forever and so on and so forth, right? That's to say what we want is a better policy making towards the welfare that these people of minority will get and how they could actually protect their children. But second of all, right, what is the likelihood under our set of the house? Look, let's characterize predominantly white country look like. Those people who are majority, like how in United States, America, for example, the majority is the white people, they are more likely tend to be oppressive towards people of minority, right? They are the because of how they have more power than them, that's to say they are more likely discriminate them even more towards the people who are not thought the people were not the part of their community as a majority to begin with, right? Because they think, but moreover, even worse, they're most likely claiming the culture of minority and so on and so forth, right? This is why we think it's so harmful to begin with. But second of all, even the likelihood of these children's development. Look, the moment these children who stick with the community who have the same historical background, there is highly unlikely that these children would get oppressed at school because they opt in into school that are part of their community and so on and so forth. If they are Chinese, they are going to opt into the school that are there are majority Chinese in that, ladies and gentlemen, and so on and so forth. Look, the moment these children could do that is that the moment these children could no longer get oppressed at school continuously, right? They will feel that they have people who have the same background. They will feel that they have people who actually understand them and their struggle, right? Opposition might say that these children will not be prepared upon their life living as minority in the future because of the exclusivity and so on and so forth. We said no, right? Just because they live in an ethnic enclave doesn't necessarily mean that they didn't get the education that they needed in the future to prepare them for their future in life, right? They still get the education that they deserve. They still have the like how my first speaker already told you, they still get the same curriculum like what people in the public school do. What we want is to give the fullest protection towards our children, right? Because we believe that full protection will lead into a better living standard for our children. Under our set of the house, if these families stick with their community in an ethnic enclave, at least these people already living with a better job than what they have in their origin country. They already live in a better condition. They get welfare and so on and so forth. Those children get a better education and so on and so forth, right? But why opening government need to wait in this debate? First of all, we are the only thing that taught you on how these people will get a better living standard that are going to lead a better development for their children if they are living in an in-class situation, right? In order to give a better protection for our children and family, we propose this motion.